Today we have a great guitar we've been waiting a long time to show you. This is Taylor's new for 2020 K26ce, the Grand Symphony, and oh, ain't it grand. We're going to go through everything about this fantastic guitar. Check it out. Hey, you're watching Alamo Music TV. My name is Chris McKee with Alamo Music Center in San Antonio, Texas. You can find us online at alamomusic.com. If you're new to our channel, make sure to subscribe, turn on notifications, and like our videos. If you'd like to support the channel, make sure to visit our Teespring store located below where you can purchase a custom designed t-shirt. So, as I mentioned at the outset, we have Taylor's new for 2020 K26ce. Now, if you're not familiar with Taylor's model designations, a K26 basically means it's part of Taylor's Koa series guitars. It is Koa topped, that's what the 2 stands for, and 6 is for the body shape, which is Grand Symphony. And they have gone and redesigned the Grand Symphony body to make it even more grand than it was before, and maybe even more symphony than it was before. And I'll explain all of that in just a moment as we go through all of the specs. But let's start here at the beginning with K. That is Koa, or more specifically, Hawaiian Koa, one of our most beloved tone woods. Hawaiian Koa is this amazingly figured, fetching tone wood from the island of Hawaii. It is the only place in the entire world that it grows, the Hawaiian Islands. And so, yes, it is kind of rare, but it is also beautiful, both to look at and to listen to. It's one of our favorite tone woods, and Taylor has been producing Koa guitars probably more so than most any other builder out there as part of their standard lineup and in limited edition models. We've done videos on many of those guitars before, like the ever popular K24ce or the Builder's Edition K14ce. I'll put a link up to that video right there so you can take a look at those guitars. Now this, in the Koa lineup, is the Grand Symphony, which is a little bit bigger body than the Grand Auditorium, which Taylor is most known for. They redesigned, or they came out with this body shape probably a little bit over a decade ago, and it was really just a little bit bigger than the Grand Auditorium at the time. It was very, very similar silhouette, a little bit more pregnant lower bout. But now it's gone through a transformation, and it really moves into its own body shape, completely separate from the Grand Auditorium, with its own bag of tricks. One of the things that you're going to notice on this guitar right off the bat as I'm holding it is this thing right here. Now, I mentioned that this is a K26ce. That C stands for cutaway. And this is kind of a bit of both scenario. It has a cutaway here in the front, but as you can see, it doesn't have a cutaway in the back. This is Taylor's new Soundport cutaway that they introduced at the NAMM show on 2 models. This model and the 816ce, which is also a Builder's Edition model. You can see a link to that guitar right there. So when we reviewed that guitar, we kind of discussed what was going on with the Soundport and the overall remainder of the design changes that took place. So let's start here first with what's going on that you can't see. This is now a Grand Symphony body with V-class bracing. Now, V-class bracing is Taylor's revolutionary new bracing pattern that Andy Powers designed that changes from an X-brace to a V pattern, starting here at the tail block and emanating up to the sides of the sound hole and up to the top here at the upper bout. It more succinctly divides the top of the guitar. Basically, what you should know is that it generates more balance with power or volume, sustain. They aren't trade-offs anymore, in other words, and it improves intonation, which we've said from the outset is kind of a weird thing, and yet it works. Part of the reason for that is the fact that the top moves in a more orderly fashion, creating overtones that are in line or linear to the note that it's originally making, and so the whole guitar is in better tune. You don't have the dissonance that sometimes can occur. Also, along the guitar neck with all of these V-class guitars, you don't have dead spots, it rings true and in tune from the nut all the way up the neck. So this is now a V-class guitar. But with every V-class guitar, I've mentioned this before, and I don't know that it's really that well marketed or explained by Taylor, but it's not just one pattern of V-brace that's on all of these guitars. It is modified a little bit for every single body shape and for series based upon the tone woods that are used. So in this particular case, it's modified for the fact that this is an all Koa guitar, all around, top, back, and sides being Hawaiian Koa that has its own unique tonal traits to it, and the fact that it's this body shape, which is the Grand Symphony body shape. With this and the 816, the changes that have come about include a really robust, vibrant tone with very little input, and they've switched from medium gauge strings to light gauge strings. What this means for the guitar when you're playing it is that you really don't have to put a lot into it to get a lot out of it. And let's focus on that, because that's kind of weird. I've gone on record, and this is really just kind of industry knowledge, that a smaller guitar, think of like a parlor guitar, or like in Taylor's lineup, a grand concert, smaller guitars are louder with a light touch than a big guitar is with a light touch. The reason is a small guitar requires less energy to move because it has less mass, right? It's just physics. In this particular case, we're playing with physics a little bit because this is a larger guitar, much larger than we'd see on, say, like a grand concert. And yet, with very little energy input, with a light touch, in other words, I'm able to really get a lot out of the guitar. Right before we started filming, we were actually noting that fact, that I wasn't really having to play hard, and yet there was a lot of volume and a lot of richness coming out of this guitar. So that comes in part because of the body shape and the bracing, the modifications that have been done to accommodate V-class bracing for the Grand Symphony body. Now, the other parts of it have to do with the fact that this is an all-Koa guitar, so that brings its own tonal characteristics to it. With a Koa back and sides combination, you're going to get a lot of warm mid-range, and you're going to get some really nice treble out of it. It's almost like this great marriage between mahogany, rosewood, and maple, so to speak. You don't have all of the bass that rosewood has, but you have pretty much all of that nice warm mid-range that you'd get from mahogany, some low mids that you typically wouldn't get, and some crystalline high-end that's really nice and bell-like that you might get from maple. Over time, Koa actually opens up to introduce more bass, which is just kind of an added bonus as you own the guitar. When you top that guitar with a Koa top, it does the same thing that happens when you top a guitar with a mahogany top. It adds some natural compression. So that's going to even out all of the dynamics. Now, what that means by even out is all of the really loud parts it's going to bring down, but all the really quiet parts it's going to bring up. Combined with V-class bracing, I've said this before and I'm going to emphasize again, that natural compression takes that increased sustain that V-class bracing provides and it doubles down on it. So because that waveform is compressed and those quiet parts are now louder and those louder parts are now, you know, a little more quieter and evened out, your sustain is increased. It's the same thing that happens with a compressor pedal or a really good tube amp that starts to compress as you add gain to it. You get more sustain. So you're going to get more sustain out of this. You're going to get that wonderful warmth. Now let's talk about the Soundport Cutaway, because I know that is probably the most jarring change that really is on these guitars and speaks to Taylor's innovation with their lineup. In other words, they're not afraid to take a guitar like this with a pretty substantial price tag and a lot of beautiful features that many of us would want, like this gorgeous Hawaiian Koa. This is a particularly nice example, by the way. And then put something so unique on it in this Soundport Cutaway. This bevel cutaway is not all the way through, as we saw, and the Soundport, which you might find from other builders maybe up here, is serving a function for you, the player. As we demonstrated on that 816CE video, what's happening is that more of the sound is coming out of this section of the guitar. In fact, you can feel it if you strum the guitar and you put your hand there. That's coming back to you, the player, and also just kind of creating this almost surround sound experience as you play the guitar, as well as for the audience. In other words, it's not just for you, but you certainly benefit from it. Now, its placement comes down to what Andy Power says, that when you put a sound port on a guitar, you may accidentally, change the sound. In other words, what's coming out of there may not be true to the sound of the guitar. But two, you might get some undesirable transients coming out of that sound port that you don't necessarily want. And so the fact that it's up here is strategic. They've done that for a very specific reason, to give you that surround sound effect and to capitalize on the design of the guitar. In other words, they haven't just taken a sound port because it's in vogue and stuck it somewhere on the guitar. There's thought that's gone into it. What's interesting about this is that it plays into something that I think a lot of us guitar players forget about. One of the great things about an acoustic guitar is that it is an intimate instrument that you can play pretty much anywhere. But there's an organic nature to it because, in effect, the guitar is breathing. As you play the guitar is acting like a sound speaker would. It's pumping, it's moving, and it's generating air out of the sound hole. That's why we have the sound hole to begin with. And that's why you can feel movement if you place your hand over this beveled sound port cutaway. Because the guitar in itself is breathing. And in this case, what Taylor has done is given another avenue for that breath, so to speak, that life, that music that comes out of the instrument, to reach you and to reach your audience. Combined with the shorter scale length, the lighter strings, and the changes to bracing, this is a fantastic, beautiful, really resonant instrument that would both excel in a solo playing environment as well as with an ensemble. We're going to put it through its paces so you can hear for yourself exactly what I'm talking about. Check it out. So there you have it, Taylor's new K26ce with that innovative beveled sound port cutaway. I, you know, if I'm honest, when I first saw it, it was a bit jarring. What is that? But isn't that the case with so many things that happen when it's innovative and it's new? We don't necessarily know what to make of it. The proof in the pudding for me was the first time sitting down with one of these instruments and playing it. For me, that was the 816 having this feature. But I am absolutely in love with this guitar. I've always loved the combination of Koa top, back, and sides. I own a Grand Symphony body personally because I really like the body shape. The changes that Taylor has implemented here really improve the instrument all around. And you deserve it to yourself if you've been interested in one of these to, as soon as you can, put your hands on one and play it for yourself and experience what's going on with the breath of this instrument. If you'd like more information about this guitar, go to our website, it's alamomusic.com. You can see all of the specs there, as well as photography of the guitars we have in stock. And feel free to chat with one of our sales associates online who can help you find the perfect instrument for you, whether it be this one or a different one. That's why we do this channel. That's why we make these videos. We want to put the right guitar into your hands, because at the end of the day, the best guitar in the world is the one that you are making music with. At least that's what we believe. So if you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe, turn on notifications. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, comment below. We'd like to hear from you. We want to help you make all of your musical dreams come true. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.